All right, why was the bill, why was it deferred in terms of sending it to the Senate?
Well, we were told, Karen, by the Secretary General that there is a need to report the amended vote to the plenary floor. So come session, after the Congress opens, then yung po ire-report po yan sa plenary floor.
Okay, so tama po ba ito? Of course, Congress is now adjourned. You resume during the State of the Nation address of President Marcos
Jr. That is correct.
July 22, after the 22nd, that same week, it goes to the floor. Will it go to the Senate that same week? So it will be the end of July.
No, after that, no, after the Congress opens, ire-report po yan. Kasi sa umaga po, normally, nag-session po kami, po pwede nilang ipasok yan.
Oo. So ang session nyo magbubukas July 22, tama ba? O 24?
Tama po, that is correct.
22. So ibig sabihin sa umaga po ng 22, it will be brought to the plenary, the amended numbers, so to speak, and then it will be sent to the Senate that morning?
Well, that is possible.
Okay. But more or less, it's fair to say that it's the week of the 22nd.
Yes, that is correct.
Now, do you see any kind of, I would have to say, danger in that sense, because 2 months have passed, right? So the supporters of the divorce bill are ecstatic about the passage of the bill in the lower house, but then you do know that it's tougher in the Senate, and the 2 months may actually affect the support or the optimism that many people feel.
That is correct. But we can also convince those people who are not in favor of the divorce bill. So it could go either way.
Okay, you heard Senate President Cheese Escudero. He said he was more in favor of actually making annulment more affordable in the Philippines. As of now, you don't even need a psychologist anymore to initiate the process of annulment. He wants a redefinition of psychological incapacity. If annulment is made cheaper, what would be the difference of a cheaper annulment process versus an absolute divorce bill?
Well, Karen, you have to understand, annulment is different from the absolute divorce, because the grounds under the annulment, it should manifest prior to the commencement of the marriage. Unlike in divorce, even subsequently after the marriage, it manifests yung mga grounds, then you can file the divorce. And under the divorce bill, There is this provision which allows summary hearing. Lima po yan na inaalaw ng summary hearing. When you say summary hearing, they can present ex parte evidence. So ibig pong sabihin yan, the petitioner can present ex parte evidence, sila lang, even without the evidence from the other side.
Oo. Now,
those are the grounds which are very obvious.
The grounds are very obvious. You have colleagues in the lower house, like Representative Richard Gomez, who voted against the divorce bill. He said, we are a predominantly Catholic country. So now it's an issue of religion. Let's talk about that. You have the Catholic Bishops Conference of the Philippines already speaking out against divorce, saying this destroys the construct, the family, right? The unit of the family.
Karen, let me first answer the one that was said by Congressman Richard Gomez. Okay. Well, actually, ako kasi binasa ko yung divorce in its entirety. Divorce is just an option. Aside from the legal separation, we have the annulment and the declaration of nullity. Divorce is an option, and it is less tedious and cheaper. than the other one. So, ito po kasing divorce, ang hindi po alam ng iba, is mas expanded. Like for example, isa po sa mga additional ground in divorce is the sex reassignment surgery. Eh halimbawa po, dati bago kayo ikasal, narsiso ka. And then eventually, you realize na sinarsisa ka pala. And then nagkaroon ka ng surgery. Yan po ba naman, hindi pa ka-divorce-divorce yun?
Oo. Pero won't that qualify also in the annulment process? Lawyers may say that proves psychological incapacity to fulfill your duties as a husband to your wife. So that would fall under annulment too. I'm just conversing with you so that the arguments for divorce become stronger, because those anti-divorce will give these arguments. Sasabihin nila, eh pwede naman sa annulment yan eh.
Karen, ulitin ko, dun sa annulment, it should manifest prior to the celebration of the marriage. Dito po kasi sa divorce, even after, dun lang nag-manifest. Dun mo lang na-realize talaga na talagang iba pala talaga yung kasarian mo. So, because if you realize that after, at hindi na patunayan sa court na ito ay it manifested even before. Like for example, before, babaero ka. Hindi naman nagmamanifest. Wala naman talagang bite. And then later on, biglang nung kinasal ka, nakatikim ka ng kapwa mo lalaki, na mas nasarapan ka. Doon lang nagmanifest at doon lang nabuhay pala yung iyong nakatago. So, hindi yun igagrant sa annulment. Unlike
pero
sa divorce, igagrant po yan.
Oh, no, the reason I'm asking this is we know how the annulment process in the Philippines works, right? So essentially, most of those who have been granted annulment, if not all, were proven to be psychologically incapable. And lawyers in this country and the psychologists too are able to maneuver that to prove that the one petitioning or the other party is psychologically incapacitated. Therefore, they grant an annulment. So, well, that's why it's become more expensive, right? Because you then hire a good lawyer, and then you hire a psychologist. You go through all this process that even if your partner is technically not psychologically incapacitated, you end up proving and lying in court that he is. That's the issue, eh, diba? Sa Pilipinas, lahat na psychologically incapacitated.
Karen, let me first correct the impression of the people that psychological incapacity is a ground for annulment. No, that is not. Psychological incapacity to comply with marital obligation is a ground for declaration of nullity, and that is different from annulment. So ito po yung isang option, yung declaration of nullity. That is the time when we need to hire a psychiatrist. But when we talk about psychological incapacity, that is to comply with marital obligation. Hindi dahil you are of sound mind. Of sound mind, po pwede po yan, doon po papasok yan sa annulment. So iba-iba po yan. Iba-ibang ground, iba-iba. Now, ano po ang pinag-aiba ng binabanggit ko kanina dito sa divorce? Yung binabanggit ko po, like yung sex reassignment surgery, ito po, it can be heard through summary proceedings. Mas mabilis lang po ito. Hindi mo na kailangan, you don't have to go through the long process of annulment or declaration of nullity. Ito po, pipresent mo lang na yung husband mo nagpapalit na ng kanyang kasarian. And the judge can make a decision. Ex parte, ito nga po yung tinatawag na ex parte evidence eh.
Okay, so for example, cases like that, they're not common cases, right? They can happen, but that's not the real issue why most women or many women want divorce to be legalized. The common issues in the Philippines are, it's really abuse, right? Domestic abuse. Binubugbog ako ng asawa ko, minumura ako ng asawa ko, or ang daming babae ng asawa ko, emotionally, I can't take this anymore. More often than not, these are the common issues of married women. Number two, may binabahay na iba ang asawa ko. He has a mistress. May pamilya na siya doon. I don't want to live this way anymore. Pangalawa yun. Pangatlo is he can't provide for me and I'm not happy anymore. I just want to be a single mother and provide for my kids and get a second chance at life. Yan ang mga common, di ba? Yan naman ang typical. When this goes to the Senate and they say, well, you can file for annulment in all of those grounds.
Those grounds are not grounds for annulment, Karen. Those grounds are grounds for legal separation. Now, what is the difference between legal separation and annulment? In legal separation, you are only separated by law in bed.
Mm-mm.
But technically, kasal pa rin kayo. Mm-mm. You are not even allowed to get married in legal separation. Unlike in annulment, you are allowed to get married. But ito nga yung confusion ng ibang tao eh. Doon sa legal separation, nandiyan po lahat ng ground ng mga binabanggit natin at nagmamanifest ito after the marriage, yung pambababae, yung pambubugbo. Kasi pag magkasintahan pa lang kayo, ang sweet ninyo eh, magka-holding hands kayo lagi eh. Sabik na sabik kayo sa isa't isa eh. But after that, after the honeymoon period, after a year, after 2 years of marriage, doon na lumalabas yung tunay na katauhan ng lalaki and then doon na nagsasuffer yung babae. Now, the question is, ang problema sa legal separation, hindi ka po pwedeng makahanap ng panibago mong partner. You're not even allowed to get married. In absolute divorce, because that ground will manifest even after the marriage, sabihin yung pambabae, yung pambubugbog, so forth and so on, but in absolute divorce, technically, pwede ka na mag-asawa ulit.
Oo. Now,
so yun ang pinagkaiba po nun.
Oo. Now, some of those opposing divorce feel that, oh, because if absolute divorce becomes a law, it's so easy to break up a marriage. Let's discuss the grounds for filing a petition for divorce under this bill.
Okay. Karen, maraming grounds dito sa absolute divorce, no?
Mm-hmm.
Isa na dito yung grounds sa legal separation, yung grounds sa annulment, mm-hmm. yung grounds sa declaration of nullity.
Mm-hmm.
And on top of that, yung mga binabanggit ko po kanina sa inyo, isinama na po dito yung pagpapalit ng kasarian.
Oo.
So pag nagpalit ka ng kasarian, pwede na yan. But isa po sa mga salient features din dito sa ground for absolute divorce is yung nakapag-asawa ka ng foreigner.
Mm.
Tapos dun sa foreign country, yung foreigner, ina-allow yung divorce. Kasi dito sa atin, hindi ina-allow yung divorce.
Mm-mm.
So, what happens now? Ang nangyayari, after the foreign divorce decree, has been granted in foreign country, kailangan i-submit mo pa dito in a judicial process.
Mm.
Kailangan pa dumaan sa korte.
Mm.
Unlike dito po, sa absolute divorce bill na ipinasa po namin, hindi na kailangan dumaan. Ang kailangan lang is i-authenticate ng Philippine consul sa ibang bansa.
Mm-hmm.
And then, i-register mo na ito sa civil registrar. So, mas mabilis.
Okay, so that's one, and it essentially benefits Filipinos who marry foreigners. And another difference of the absolute divorce bill is you only need court proceedings. Kasi for many Filipinos, when they file for annulment, you need to get annulled in court, but they also petition for annulment to the Catholic Church, right? Am I correct,
yes.
Representative?
So yes, you are correct.
Really spending for two, right? So I know
yes.
some couples who filed for annulment with a court, but they did not even touch the Catholic Church anymore. They left it because you can actually remarry, I mean, in a Christian ceremony, right? But what really
yes.
holds, what really matters in terms of legal rights is you getting married before the court at the end of the day, right?
Yes, right. And you have to take into consideration, Karen, na marami dito sa atin, hundreds of Filipinos could not afford church marriage. So kadalasan civil rights lang yan eh. Marami po yan. Well, based on my experience as a counselor, talagang puro civil lang po yung mga ginagawa.
Okay. Now, what do you think is really, what's the biggest hindrance in the Philippines? Because you know what's interesting? Ireland, which is predominantly Catholic, right? And extremely, yes. Ireland has already legalized divorce. So there are only two, I wouldn't say countries per se, but in the world, the Philippines and the Vatican City. Imagine it's the Vatican. In effect, tayo na lang ang nag-iisang sovereign nation na hindi pa legal ang divorce. Ireland, which is predominantly Catholic, has legalized it. What is stopping us? What do you believe is it?
Well, siguro marami kasi sa atin dito. To be honest with you, medyo malakas pa rin ang influence ng Roman Catholic Church, no?
Oo. But isn't it the same in Ireland? I mean, Ireland is predominantly Catholic, and yet the lawmakers were able to pass divorce.
I do not know about
the surveys.
But we are more traditional. Mas traditional tayo eh. So, in fact, sa atin, mas, in fairness naman sa mga Pilipino, mas respectful tayo, traditional, we adhere to our customs. So, yun talaga yung ano, and what, more than, gano'n na po katagal ang Katoliko dito sa atin, more than 300, 400 years. So, medyo malalim yung pagkakabaon po sa atin. But you know, Karen, as a legislator kasi ako I do not look at it that way, no. I do not vote based on my religion. Yeah. You always have to consider what is just and what will benefit for the Filipino people, because ako, lack of option, I believe, is a form of poverty.
Yeah.
Karen.
Very good.
So
That's a very good point. Mm-mm.
Everyone deserves to be happy, Karen. And I believe if we are going to curtail the right of our people, this is not mandatory, Karen. Baka akala ng mga kababayan natin na once this is passed, obligado ka na mag-divorce. No. Hindi po ito mandatory. This is just an option. If you're happy with your family, I'm happy for you. You don't have to file a petition for divorce. What about those who are not? Mm-hmm. What about those who are living in misery? Karen, divorce law is not an enemy. Mm-hmm. You have to remember that.
Yeah.
The divorce law is a form of relief given by the state to the people who are suffering from marital abuse and oppression.
Oo. Yeah.
Yan po yan eh.
And frankly, not only that, because in most marriages, I mean, this is all over the world, the one who benefits from divorce, if needed, is really the woman. Because in an abusive marriage, it is the woman who loses her rights. If divorce is legalized, you empower the woman, the mother. But then how do you feel that you have lawmakers who actually speak this way? Nako, ang saya ng pamilya ko. Hindi ko kailangan ng divorce. Nako, I'm happy in my marriage. Right? They make it about them.
Well, If you're happy with your family, we're happy for you.
That's the kind of thinking that some lawmakers have. It's about them.
Karen, let me ask you one question. How do you define family?
Yeah.
Mm-mm. Diba? Family is what? Respect, joy, love, protection. For me, that is how I define family. Now, if one lacks respect in family, masaya ka pa ba? Ginugulpi ka? Mm-hmm. And lahat ng babae po deserves to be respected.
Mm-mm. Mm-mm. Okay, if the divorce becomes law, now we know that this is meant to benefit the poorest of the poor, ang mga pinakamahihirap na kababaihan who cannot afford a fancy lawyer or go to PAW, walang oras. How simple, I don't want to use the word simple, but how accessible would it be for women to be able to actually, it gives them more rights. This gives them a voice. What is the process? Do they go to a family court? Is it one court? Is there a lawyer assigned to the court? How many days is this?
Karen, we have, under the divorce law, we have this so-called court-assisted petitioner. Mm-hmm. So yung court-assisted petitioner, ang definition po nito, those who are with the property of less than 2.5 million pesos. So pag ang property mo, whether na real or personal property, is worth 2.5 million pesos, you will be given free legal assistance by the court. Mm-hmm. Now, how do we go about it? Kung pwede po to, pag nag-apply ka at na-approvehan ka, so pag pati even pagpa-file mo po ng petition for absolute divorce is free of charge. And even if there is a need for the psychiatrist or kung sino mang mga expert witness dyan, there is the DSWD, Department of Social Welfare and Development, who will assist you into this. So lahat dito po sa absolute divorce bill, kinonsider po yan to make it easier, to make it less cheaper, and to make it more affordable, especially to those people who are in dire need.
All right. So on that note, I think at the end of the day, that this is already the litmus test, because it's the first time the absolute divorce bill has actually passed the lower house. And when you think of it in our history, what's interesting is during the American colonial period, the Philippines had divorce. It was Act 2710. It became a law in 1917. It was repealed and expanded during the Japanese period in 1943. Then in 1950, it diminished and just allowed legal separation. But technically speaking, there was divorce in the Philippines in the early 1900s. All right. Siguro ang huling tanong ko na lang, Representative, the president's voice will be powerful on this one. He's not speaking about it. He's been silent when it comes to divorce. May panawagan po ba kayo sa Pangulo?
Well, sa akin po, ang panawagan ko po sa Pangulo sana po tignan po niya. He should be a voice. He should be a leader, not only of a certain sector. He is a leader of the Filipino people. And definitely, everyone deserves to be happy. Sana po, tignan din po niya ang mas nakararami.
On that note, I want to thank you so much for joining me today, Representative Joel Chua. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.